Is scavenging worth it? The answer is today we're going to take a look and see.
Is scavenging worth it?
What is scavenging? And you're going to see scavenging data from level 12 through 61. Yes, I know a person just crazy enough to document the whole experience. With that being said, let's get into it real quick. Just in case you're new, scavenging is a, I guess just like, it's looking for loot, right? And it's going to give you random loot depending on what your scavenging level is. I'm going to go ahead and hit the scavenging button right here. This is considered basic scavenging, and it's advised not to hit this button, okay? For the most part. Okay, I got 2 metal bits, 2 ice, okay? Not a whole lot there. Now, what if I want to do advanced scavenging, which is what you'd want to do normally? Let's take a look. You want to go to the marketplace, go to tools, type in scav, look for the novice tool or the cheapest tool for the amount of uses. Now, the novice tool gives you 50 uses. So, and it tends to be the cheaper one most of the time. So we're just going to go with that. All right. So we got our scavenging tool and let's open it. So we're going to go to inventory. Here's our tools right here. Oh, there you go. Now you can see it. Boom. Open. Got it. Now we got 50 uses we can do with this thing. Oops, wrong button. There we go. Okay. Now when you scavenge, it's going to use stamina. I think it's 1 per click. So we'll go ahead and demonstrate that. Boom, 1 stamina, got 3 sunflower seeds and 4 bits. So already was better than the basic scavenge. So, ooh, I got some art. Art is good if you have a gallery. If you don't have a gallery, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Just collect the art for now. 32 regolith on that one. Let's see. Oh, I got glitched art. So it's all going to vary now. All right, let's look real quick. So when you go to level this, scavenging is probably one of the most friendly things there is. It needs no books to level. So once you have the XP and you have a little stam, a little dusk, you can level it up. The lower level it is, the less is required of you, you know, to level it up. But let's look at some data. Let's look at some data. I'm gonna press the button one more time. Electronic bits. All right. Scavenging 12 all the way to 63. We have it all right here. So we're gonna take a peek at this at the end of this. So we got level 12 through 14. And with 50 clicks, this is all of these runs on the sheet. I'm gonna share the sheet down below, by the way. You can take a peek at it. All these runs are with a level 50 tool or a 50 use tool, novice tool. This person is Thinker. You know Thinker from the T sheet. He also helped with the solar sheet. If you appreciate Thinker, I'm gonna go ahead and put his wallet here. Only donate to him if you are in a position to do so. If you're not, if you're new and you're struggling with the game, just focus on yourself for now. But if you do appreciate Thinker's work, here's his address, his wallet address. So anyway, here's the data and it's 50 uses. So now the price for that he paid for the tool isn't in here because it won't really matter anyway, because the price today of the tool is probably less. So let's just go through this data. So level 12 through 14, 50 uses. He got about 67 market price worth of dusk. The actual dusk part is when he when Thinker sold. So there's 65. And let's see, you got level 14 through 16, 107. 16 through 18 weren't that great at 67. You got another 61 right here for the next run. Level 20 through 22 actually picked up. And this is 93 market price. So if you're paying, you know, 75 for a tool or whatever it is right now, you are kind of coming out ahead depending on what your food and water costs are. So you have to factor that in as well. Now, if we keep going, you start to see these prices kind of stabilize around the 80 through 100. Here we have 25 through 27, 160. Dust worth of market price value. Let's see here. And it kind of jumps in that range around level 27 through 28. The event kicked in. That was the scavenging event that we had, which it was actually a really cool event. I liked it. It's the only reason my scavenging is as high as it is, because I really didn't want to scavenge. Like, it sounds cool, but I decided not to go like a whole lot into scavenging. But the event was so good that like, it got me excited about scavenging. So you can see, you know, we'll kind of skip through some of these. We got, 180, 120. It kind of hangs on that range a little bit. There's 33 to 34. We're down quite a bit at 75. And basically, you just want to see, you just want to compare, like, what is the tool cost now? What is your stamina cost? And can you make a profit? So we're going to jump down to the latest and greatest runs. Now, this is some more recent stuff. This is 51 to 52. Well, let's go back a little bit. Thinker leveled a lot during the event. 244 market. Market prices level 55 through 57. Let's see here. Level 57, 154. 118, 94. Oh, here we go. Dang, 58 to 59, 207. Where's the value? Then you got 118. It kind of bounces around, so I almost want to say, like, if making tools is profitable, if making your own scavenging tool is profitable, and doing this, you're probably going to come out ahead. Or if you find the tool at a cheap price. Okay, look at these are the latest and greatest ones right here. So we got level 62, 156 worth of dusk. Level 62 to 63, 144 worth of dusk. So if we go back, the tool costs 73. If the tool's costing 73 and you're getting lucky on your finds, and it's gonna, your level's gonna vary, right? Maybe not as much as you think. I mean, some of those early levels were popping off pretty good too. It seemed like once you got into the 20s and like late 30s, things were pretty good. I don't know. The data's here. It seems like scavenging is okay. There's some luck involved. If you get the tool for cheap, you'll be fine. Right here, we have the 3D print shop. If you get to a point, make it a point. Make your own tools. It's profitable, at least right now. You make your own scavenging tool. You're gonna save some money versus buying it on the market. The build cost is about 60 right here. And if you're pulling in 60 dusk, or you know, 100, 150 dusk when you're doing these scavenges, I think that's pretty good. Also have to consider your stamina cost and things like that. But if you're self-sufficient in your food or water, that'll help you out. Thinker basically allocates 50 stam to scavenging a day, and one tool per day is logging the data. The link will be down below. You can look at that. It will be updated, I guess, daily or when Thinker gets around to it. But pretty cool. I think there is some value there. I don't know if it's a lot, but if you can make your own tool and it's cheaper to make your own tool, then you might be okay. So you're going to want to do your 3D print shop, figure out what you need to do to make these. You can buy the aluminum ore, buy the PVC. Basically, you can buy everything here. The only thing you won't be able to buy is the levels. I would check in the mom Discord to see what's the best XP per level. I guess you could run some PVC. That's probably going to be super expensive. Okay, so honestly, I think the best way to make your scavenging tool is to probably have a 3D print shop, have all the mats, and job it out, because you're probably not going to have the scavenging or the fabrication XP or the fabrication level 5. So if you're looking to scavenge and you have a 3D print shop, you can get the mats. It's going to build cost you for about 60. So you're going to save a You're going to save some dusk there, make the tool, and then start scavenging. So, or just buy the tool outright and you'll save some time. But I would consider maybe having some tools made. You're just going to have to job them out, because getting to Fab 5 might be a little costly, but I would again check in the mom Discord and get some further information. So, hope you appreciate this scavenging. It seems to be okay. Like, it could be better. It's just going to depend on your luck and what you're getting the scavenging tool for. I don't know if the art takes away from, you know, maybe what you could be earning, because sometimes the art might take place of something you could sell, because right now you can't sell the art, but that will probably change in the future. So just look forward to that if that is the case. Yeah, that's about it. That's all I got. Is scavenging worth it? The answer is it depends. I think it's pretty cool. Scavenging is pretty cool. If you decide to go that route, let me know how your scavenging's let me know how it's going for you. I think when you get vibes, that is probably one of the best things you can find, at least in my eyes, because them vibes are selling for quite a bit right now. So anyway, good luck on your scavengings. I'll catch you in the next one.